I do not want to hear this talk from you again. Doubt is heavier than a week's snow.
Forgive me, my chieftain. We will be ready for the next attempt.
But this will not be an attempt. It must be done. Do you understand?
My chieftain.
Good. Outlander, I suppose you wish to speak?
Aurea knows about this, Damon. Where would I talk to her?
She does a shaman's work. That is not for the eyes and ears of others. Certainly not an Outlander's.
This Damon you talked about.
If you are hardy enough, you can venture out and see the signs yourself. It has changed the machines, made them fiercer, stronger.
But what is it?
A matter for the shamans to debate.
There are other Werraks in Song's Edge, too?
Yes. The village has its own life for all Banuk who need trade or shelter. After the war ended, it sprang up from what was once a campsite, quick as the bloom between frosts. Perhaps it will last until the Karja seek war again.
Did your Werrak come from this place?
No, he rallied most of our hunters from across Banur to face the threat of the demon. But I was born here and stayed to fight the Karja when others retreated into the mountains. A few of my old warriors remained with me, those who survived.
You're set on going back to the mountain?
I have put my word to it.
Even with the risks being so great?
The risk of what? Death? It would be a worse fate to bow our heads to the challenge and say too much.
Well, I guess that's it then.
Good. I prefer deeds to words.
Right. You seem sad, stranger. I heard you mention a flood?
Yes. A sudden deluge, without rain or melt to explain it. I'm Laolai, the drummer of Deep Din. Or at least I was, until it disappeared under the waters.
Deep Din? What's that?
A hollow, carved out by the old ones. A chamber, a basin, and a musical instrument all at once. My life, my calling. I'd explain it by playing for you if I could, but its pipes are deep under the water now.
So Deep Din is a place, and a musical instrument?
Yes. Pipes that carry a perfect tone beneath a sonorous basin. A wondrous edifice the old ones used to carry music far and wide. During the war, my father played the pipes to rally the Banuk against the Karja. I'm the drummer now, but our battles are few and far between. Mostly I play for the joy of it, or to remember my family. Of course, if the waters don't recede, what's the point of joy? Or remembering?
A flood without rain. That is strange. Where is this place? I'll have a look if I'm in the area.
Just northwest of here. Look all you like, but I don't see what good it'll do. The floodwaters aren't going anywhere. How does one ask a river to relent?
Thank you. deep in.
I remember the red rays and the outlander. I know what outsiders live.
Okay, if I want to learn more about how this daemon affects the machines, I've got to find Rhea. And to do that, I need to talk to her apprentice, who followed the river north. Urban said Araya's apprentice went north of the river. Hopefully not too far. That must be Naltuk, looking out at that tower.
Naltuk?
Who are you? How did you find me?
Bergrund told me you'd be out here.
He's persistent. I've told that Osteram 1,000 times. I don't need to buy anything.
And I'm not selling. I just need to find Araya.
Well, you won't. She's gone where only shamans can tread. She seeks guidance from the voice in the blue light. That is her task. And the task she gave me is to observe the daemon's work. To stop it spreading, if I can. What can I do about these towers? In only a few weeks, they've sprouted throughout the cut. The daemon's energy pulses from them, rallies the machines, even repairs them.
Aratok said this daemon was frenzying machines?
Look there. Those with the purple markings. They belong to the daemon. They're stronger, more dangerous.
I've seen something like this before. A corruption. But it wasn't from your daemon.
You have? Well, then you know more than I do. These towers, were they part of your corruption?
No. Those are new to me, too.
Like I said, they empower the daemon's machines. They must be stopped.
Will you tell me where Araya went?
You ask a lot of questions.
Only when I'm not getting the answers I need.
There's but one voice Araya wants to hear right now, and it isn't yours. I'm sorry.
All right. You want to stop the spread of the daemon's work? I know how to get started. With my bow and spear.
Outlander, wait. Won't you tell me your name?
Aloy.
Good. If you fall to the daemon's machines, at least I can properly recount your efforts to Araya.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. But I won't fall. And when I'm done, you're gonna tell me where she is.
Thank you.
can be destroyed.
You are quite the warrior. We should speak.
Now we know how to deal with the machines in the towers. The daemon's next.
Perhaps Aurea should meet you after all. What she truly seeks is hope. After what I just saw, you could show her that. She's in retreat beyond those mountains, the ice rasps. You'll have to walk the shaman's path to get there. You'll know you've reached the end when you come to a shrine, a great machine covered in blue gleam. Shamans who complete the path take a piece of it as reward. If you make it that far, you should too. You'll have earned it.
You said something about blue gleam at the end of the shaman's path?
A crystal that builds on the bodies of machines in the oldest ice. We Banuk believe it's the stuff of the blue light, frozen as it escapes their shells. You might be more interested that merchants will trade well for it.
Bergrin told me you're Aurea's apprentice.
In her absence, I serve the chieftain and his werak as an advisor, a scout, a speaker for the blue light.
A lot of responsibilities.
I don't know if I can live up to Aurea's example, but I have to try. I owe her that much. She took a chance on me, an aspiring shaman from the edge of the world. No one else would.
How do I cross this shaman's path?
Go to the ice rasps. Then follow the markers through the ice caves and the waterfalls, and make the climb to the shrine. But be careful. The path is meant to be an ordeal, the final trial of a young shaman's training.
And I'll find Aurea at the end of it?
No. She goes further up, somewhere inside the mountain. If you see her, would you tell her, I have faith she will hear the voice again.
All right, I guess I'm off to the ice rasps to find this shaman's path. These mountains must be the ice rasps. The shaman's path begins somewhere up above. Be too prepared. I'm pretty far up. The shaman's path must be right. This must be one of the markers Nal'tuk told me about. Looks like each marker points to another, giving directions. Guess I'm heading deeper into the cold, creepy ice cave. This isn't the way out. Some gear, though. If there's more, maybe my focus can find them. Not this way. Back after I grab this loot. Yep, focus can pick up the chimes. Should help me find my way. Another marker. Good. Dead end. But at least there's stuff. Thank you. up. Chime. Not sure I saw this fork before.
Stars, one way or another.
Done with the cave. So what's next on this path? Here's the way. I need to pull the rope to move this thing into position. Okay, the bridge is filling up. This one. Pull the rope to move this thing into position. Okay, the bridge is filling up. exaggerating. There's definitely something new out here. And I don't think it's friendly.
I don't know.